Okay, so there we are. We have a terminal app and we have the trail cam images for our image sequence. There's an SD card in there. In the SD card is the folder DCIM. And there is four folders, and in each folder is 1,000 images. Those images contain those pictures. Let me make this a little smaller. So this is the picture of the camera, and so I want to make a time-lapse video out of it, since this is single images. Okay, so let's try this. So this is the folder that contains the four folders with all the images. Okay, and then I have here my terminal. Let's put this up here. There's my terminal. Now I need a destination folder. So I need something where I can put this video. And for that, I'm gonna make a new folder in here. Put a name video. I'm gonna put this in here in the same thing. May take longer, but okay. So here is my console. And I open this up a little, make it bigger so that you can read better. And with FFmpeg, we are going to do this. So FFmpeg is the software. Minus F image to, so the minus F is to force this image to minus pattern type is global, GLOB. And the input is this. So we need to put the input in string because I have strange paths. So the input is this folder, the DCM, this one. And in this folder, we're looking in all folders for star.jpg files. And that's our input. So this is the pictures we take in. And now what we're going to do with it. Minus R for recursive. I think it is. Do we want 30 frames in a second? Minus V codec. So video codec. Codec. Video codec. We want ProRes. Because we want ProRes. Because we want to take this into Final Cut Pro. And now we need a place where we want to put this. So we put this into this video folder. Here, video. And we name this thing timelapse.move or MPEG-4. We can do dot move. We can do, yeah, move. Let's do move. Like this, and then I hit enter. And then what is happening now, we can see here, down here, that it does picture 77 now. It does 10 frames a second in the moment. And it's creating this video. Now, I have four folders with 1,000 pictures, so it's 4,000 frames. This is how long it will take. If I want to interrupt this and stop this, I could press the Q key on the keyboard to stop this. Other than that, I just wait until I get a response here. And when we're done there, we look at our image. We look at our video when it's done. I'm going to pause this recording here, and then I come back once it's done. So now we are done here, and it says here Mac Pro, right? So this is when it's done. We did 4,799 frames. It took 2 minutes and 39 seconds. And don't forget, this is full resolution 4K. Up here we have a resolution warning. Depreciated pixel format used. Forget about this warning. In our video folder now here, we have the time-lapse movie. It has 11 gigabytes, but that's because it's raw, not compressed anything. And if we look at this here, there's my movie. Let me make this view a little smaller. I'm going to make it smaller so that you can see it. It's outside your screen here. Here, and then you can scroll through fast. Because this is the ProRes, you know, the scrolling here is easy. So, and you see here on my time-lapse that it started snowing here around this time. And it goes up the snow, see, it snows all night. And the next morning it goes away again. It thaws out or compacts or whatever. What you can do here back and forth, you see how the snow is coming. Yeah, wow. Snow. But yeah, so this is your ProRes, Hi-Res time-lapse as a movie, and you can import that then into your Final Cut Pro and make a movie out of it. Change the speeds and stuff in there, faster, slower, whatever you want.